Hey, what's up YouTube, headphones and stuff, coming at you with a video that I think it's around time I make. This is a collection video as of right now, like towards the end of January 2018, for my Golf Wang, as well as just the little tiny bit of Odd Future stuff I have from when I first started getting into Tyler and all that. So yeah, to start out, I think I should just start out with like some of the first things I ever got. You know, I started out basic with like Odd Future socks, you know, classic Zoomies gear. This was like the first shirt I ever got. More of like a pajama shirt now, just cause it's a little hard to wear that on the back without getting cringed at. Not that I care, but I cringe at myself, so I kinda care. Okay, now I think it's appropriate to get into some Golf Wang accessories and, you know, non-like shirt and hoodie type stuff, as well as some like, like collector's items. So to start off, this is a recent purchase here. This is the Golf 3D belt. I wear it pretty much every day. I got it way too big, so I had to put holes in it. But it's pretty decent. It's really thin, though. Definitely not worth, like, the $70 I paid for it. You know, decent quality. It seems to be holding up pretty well. Like, I know it looks worn down, but that's because I had to put the holes in it, so there's extra stress there. My Tyler CDs that I have, the first one I got was Wolf, because that's kind of when I started getting into him. I knew who he was when Goblin was around, back in like 2010-11. I had seen stuff with him, but I never dug into it. I was just kind of young back then. Let's take a look at the inside of this here. Credits here, original screenplay. There's the CD. Interesting album artwork. It's actually well put together. It's like a three-piece thing here. Next up, you know, right when Cherry Bomb came out, I always get my CDs from Amoeba Music online, not the store, because I don't live in LA, but I ordered Cherry Bomb, and that randomly shipped out any cover it wanted. So I got the one with the dude with the cigarettes peeing his pants. At first it was like my least favorite cover, but now I kind of like it because it kind of fits the album a little bit, just like craziness. Back there, Cherry Bomb. Right there. CD. And then the booklet inside, I'll show you right now.
This is actually the booklet that came inside. On the other side, it has all the track listings with a picture of one of his jackets that has drawing on the inside of it, but I hung up this part as a poster.
Next up, we have both covers of Flower Boy.
Here's the classic one, the painting. Couldn't get my photos in time. Let's look at the credits for this one.
It's kind of cool because
these pictures here taken in New York were taken within a few days of me seeing him in Philly by accident at the Roots picnic. He was right in front of me, and he pretty much had the same shirt on and shoes. And this was just a few days afterwards. But, you know, just little pictures and images for all the songs. And then his flower chain, which I've seen in person.
Really cool.
And then we have the explicit cover. That's supposed to look like a cassette tape, kind of. Same inside, same disc. That looks like a B. Or that has a B on it, I should say. That on the back.
I do have a Flognaw Motors keychain. I'll put a little picture up here of that, but it broke,
And I think it was just laying around in a drawer. I'm not sure where it is right now. So I do have that as well. Up next, we got the Cherry Bomb documentary. I ordered this with the bundle. The inside just pretty much has the disc. Kind of sucks that they put it online, even though it's a really cool video, but I kind of was hoping it would stay exclusive, but that's kind of impossible in the digital world now. And then here's the signed poster that came with the Cherry Bomb documentary. I didn't get any of the cool signatures, I just got the regular Tyler one. But you know, I got that framed hung up right there. Up next, we got the golf book, which I personally really like. You got this if you were subscribed to Golf Media really early on. I remember it took forever for it to come out, but it just pretty much has like everything like during the Cherry Bomb era. Tons of like interviews, clothing, sketches, the lookbook for that season, talking about making the album. Really cool. I've got an issue of Golf Digest from I think last year that talks about Tyler just because of Golf Wang, so they're talking about golf. Thought that was pretty funny. It's like a 3-page like spread here. Pretty neat. Okay, so now let's get into hats. The first hat I ever got from golf was from one of those classic throwback seasons. I think this was 2014 or 15. But this was a really cool season with a really cool lookbook. I personally don't know why. I should have got the green version of this hat because I never wear this now. I'm just not a fan of it anymore. But it was super comfy while I did wear it. As you can see, you got like the old golf tags. The old lining. Still a nice hat though. I have the blue corduroy snapback. I never really wore this much either. I got it on like a Black Friday sale. I really love the color in the corduroy. It just kind of is like a boxy look, so it doesn't really fit me well. But Tyler wore this a lot. It brings back a lot of like memories of watching older videos from him during like the Wolf era, kind of. Got the Pacific Blue Cherry Bomb Old Man hat, or strap back if you want to call it that. I wore this quite a bit. As you can see, it's dirty just because I love the color, and I really did like Cherry Bomb as an album, despite what some other people say. You have the golf tag right there. Maine, USA. Yeah, really nice hat. I like it. And now on to, like, probably my two, like, most, like, nostalgic, like, favorite to buy, like, pieces. This 5-panel. I remember just seeing pictures of Tyler wearing it, and I was like, oh my gosh, that looks so cool. I don't wear it a lot anymore. I just kind of keep it on the shelf, because my style kind of changed a little bit, so I don't wear hats much anymore, so it's kind of hard, especially with this bold hat. Once in a while, maybe, though, for an outfit, I'll take it out. But yeah, really nice throwback, pink stripe inside. And then I also have the red version of that hat. I wore this a lot too. I would say this one fits my style more just because of I have a lot of red, even though I'm not a huge red fan, but I end up having a lot of red shirts and stuff. We have the cream with like the mint blue G right here. This hat I wore the crap out of because it went with everything. As you can see, it's all like brown and yellow, but that just is, that's a good thing. You had like the goldish little like strap there. Maine, USA. Yeah, good hat while it lasted durability wise. Next up, we got the yellow snapback. I remember when this went up on the site, I immediately got it because in the season that I think this came out in, they dropped the pink and green ones, which were actually the strap backs, and I remember I could have got those, but I slept on them, and then I wanted them really bad afterwards, so when they came out with the hats with the same logo, and especially in the blue and yellow colorway, I had to jump on that. I also had to get the red and blue because another color combo that, I don't know, just entices me a lot. The blue stitching on there just goes, like, so nicely with the red hat. And it's funny because I've actually lost this hat so many... I've probably lost this hat 3 times for, like, weeks at a time. Just in random places for some reason. Up next, we got the red suede with the cat logo with the blue eyes. I was gonna say kill cat, but that's not really accurate anymore. Red suede at the top, snap back type of hat. Wore this one quite a bit, went on vacation with this one. Nice hat, quality of the suede's nice. The smiley face hat with like the denim and red, I wore this a lot. This is a really good quality hat. Like, the sides are really thick. It does kind of look a bit, it kind of sticks out on the sides because the sides are so thickly built. But I drew a little bit on this and I wore this a lot. But a really nice hat. One of my favorites to wear just because it's so simple, yet the materials are so nice. And then my most recent hat is the Problem Child hat in white. Really like how all the embroidering is in that really like vibrant different colors that really reflect well. Really nice hat. And to finish it off, we have this red checkered hat with the light blue accents. I never really wore this much. I kind of got it and realized that it would be really hard to wear with a lot of outfits. But the colorway, I just love, so I had to hop on it. I kind of regret I didn't get the green, blue, and orange one, too, because that one's grew on me a lot. And then to add, I also had, like, the cat eyes hat in yellow and the pink G hat, but I ended up selling both of those. The cat eyes hat, I just really didn't like, and I wanted some extra money. The pink one... I just thought it would be really hard to go with outfits, and I wouldn't look good in it, so I sold that too. Next up, we have beanies. I only have 2 beanies from Golf. I have this one from an older season. This is just the blue Golf, like straight up plain yellow embroidery. Blue Golf with the kill cat on the back. And then way deep in the inside, an older tag. This is a really old item, but it's a thick beanie. I wear it every once in a while now if I have an outfit that matches it. And then I have this beanie, which I really love. It kind of matches this hat, even though the stitching's a little darker on the hat. This beanie's like a more knitted beanie, so the material's a lot thinner, and I actually like snagged it on like something before, so it pulled the thread. So it's kind of like a little messed up, but I still wear it all the time. It's super lightweight though, not like the warmest beanie. And there's no like, there's a little tag on the inside. I didn't even realize that. But yeah, nice beanie as far as looks go. Okay, let's get into Golf shirts. I'll start out with this one. This one was just sitting on my bed. It's dirty because I just wore it. But it's the Flower Boy Tour tee. In bright pink with the blue B on it, and then it says Flower Boy Tour on the back. I was down there, Lancaster, PA, the smallest venue on the tour, ridiculously small, which I was so happy about. It was so intimate. Up next, we have a really nice piece. This is the blue Flognaw Motors shirt. I think this came out like 2016, I want to say. I wear this all the time, really like the color and the Flognaw Motors. I buy a lot of the stuff that says Flognaw Motors because I like cars myself. Right here we got the striped orange and blue shirt with just the blue Golf there. I got this on sale, I think, for like Black Friday 1 year because when it first dropped it was way too expensive. Pretty like lightweight thin shirt. I kind of sweat in it a lot for some reason, I don't know why. The tag's attached, it's not printed on. But definitely an interesting look. Next, we have one of my favorites, just because the memories behind it. It's the anti-golf shirt. I forget what the original name is. It's the name of, like, the serial killer dude who's on the photo. But this was the shirt I was wearing at the Roots picnic when I first, like, accidentally ran into Tyler. I mean, I didn't run into him, but he was right in front of me. But he didn't notice I was there, but it was still really cool. But yeah, I was wearing this. And then probably maybe the rarest t-shirt I have is the Cherry Bomb documentary shirt in collaboration with Illegal Civ. I was wearing this to the Lancaster Tyler show. The tag there is the Illegal Civ golf tag. A little bit different. That's why it's all like stretched out and worn out. But good memories behind that one too. Up next we have the Keep the O's shirt. It's supposed to be like modeled after Pharrell's grill. The reason I got this shirt is because Keep the O's, in my opinion, is a really like underrated song. If you really listen to Tyler when he talks about what that song's supposed to be about, I don't know, it really just like motivates me kind of. There's the tag on the inside. But yeah, and also Pharrell's a huge inspiration. Up next we have probably color-wise like my favorite golf shirt, and quality-wise probably the best like straight shirt from golf. This is like the rainbow logo with the blue stripes. You have like the embroidered tag, even though like my stitching came undone a little bit for some reason, with like the extra one there, which is a little bit itchy, but I appreciate the quality. The embroidering's really nice. Overall, really nice quality t-shirt. It's pretty thick. It lasts. I like it. And then I think this is my last shirt. I guess if you could call this a shirt. It's the soccer jersey with in the red stripes. Reason I got this is because I remember kind of when I first started getting into golf, or more into golf as a brand, and exploring Tyler as a person more. I remember seeing like the black striped one all around, because that's around that time period. Like, I think that might have been the, I think that was like the second golf lookbook that the black one was in. So when the red striped one came out, I had to get it. Only thing that irritates me about this shirt is the material just like snags onto everything, so it's really easy to like get little like, not tears, but little like marks on it and stuff. But it's a really cool t-shirt, kind of unique for golf. It's printed on, I think it was like $90 though. The embroidered patches, they kind of get a little like, if you put it in the wash, they kind of get a little crinkly. But it's all good. Still a really cool shirt. Don't wear much anymore, but definitely has good memories. Oh, forgot the most important grail type shirt I have. Because it was in my other closet. It's the Flames button-up. It's a little wrinkled right now because I think it was ran through the wash and kind of sitting weird when I dried it. But I got this the first drop it came out. I mean, I'll admit it was overpriced, but now with resale value, it's not really. Because I could get my money back plus a lot now if I really wanted. But I'm not going to get rid of the shirt. It's so historic. It was on the cover of Cherry Bomb in the Death Camp music video. You have Flognow Motors printed there. Then the All Over Flames print with like the golf in it. Golf on the tag. There was like some stitching, a little bit of like bad stitching on it when I first got it, but I kind of fixed it up a little bit. But yeah, this is probably like my most like hyped up piece maybe that I have. And rare, hard to get. And now on to hoodies. I believe I only have two. To start out, I have the all-over red stripe hoodie with the cat logo in the blue. It's a patch. This is back when golf had like the hoodies that had the text on the little like inlet or eyelets or whatever they're called, like at the end of the shoestrings. One said golf and the other one said Wang. And as well as the tag right here, golf, and then Wang on the other side. And then the tag on the inside said Golf Wang, and the lining also said Golf Wang. So, like, this season they had a lot of detail put into these. This one is actually, it kind of fits big on me. So when I wear it, I kind of look like a circus tent. But I still wear it every once in a while, just because I love red stripes. And then, I think this is the only hoodie I have, only other one I have from Golf. This is a pretty, like, rare, sought-after one. This is, like, the Kelly Green, just plain Golf, from, I think, the same season as the red stripe one. As you can see, it had, like, the similar tag. This was, like, a really good quality hoodie. They came out with, like, the gray and blue one, as well as, I think, maybe one other color. I'm not exactly sure. I know they had a blue one with red embroidering, but it never came out, and I was upset about that because it was in the lookbook. And then, as you can see, the Golf Wang, and same thing. Really soft inside, thick hoodie. But yeah, really nice quality. Again, this one fits big. I don't know why I was like ordering an XL back then, but I was. I guess I like the baggier look. But yeah, pretty sought after item. I kind of just keep it up a lot because it doesn't fit me very well. But it's a nice collection piece for sure. And then this is my only jacket I have from Golf. This is like the kind of like windbreaker varsity style coat in like this waterproof like blue material. That's kind of like wrinkly like a diaper. You have the blue like fuzzy Golf logo there, and then the same thing like big on the back, and then you have like a loose like hanging Golf tag there with another one there that's kind of fading. But this is really nice. I wear this whenever it rains pretty much. It was really expensive, but I got it for like a present, I think for like Christmas. Because it got restocked or something. So, yeah. Alright, and I think that's it for everything except for the shoes, which I'm going to cover right now. The first ones I got were the pink-soled old schools. I went from where I live, kind of. I live like an hour outside of Philly in Pennsylvania. So I traveled about an hour and a half into New Jersey to a small skate shop to get the pink bottom ones. I remember when I first got these, I was only going to get the green with the pink sole. And then when I got there, I kind of just suckered out and I bought all three pairs of, I got the wheat ones, the blue ones, and the green ones. I sold the wheat ones, which I shouldn't have done, but I never really wore them and I felt like they were like the least cool color out of all of them. But now kind of I realized they would match a lot more. But these are definitely like more popping, like historic type colorways for sure. Let's get the blue one over here. That blue suede, really nice color with the pink sole that once you kind of wear it a lot, it starts to get a lot of like whiteness to it because it kind of gets, the color gets scraped off. These were back when he was with Syndicate for Vans. This was his second Vans collab. They had the wheat, the green, and the blue, and then an unreleased black pair. Syndicate on the tag. You had the cats all over, with like the old school type Golf Wang logos. And then just the brown sole on the bottom. And then we had the green ones here. With the really nice green suede with the pink bottoms. Brown, same cats all over the inside. And the tongue. These Golf Wang Vans came in the white box, the Syndicate that pulls out and has the cats all over the inside, as well as the bag. And then up next, I went to Philly around when Cherry Bomb came out to get the next Vans collabs. I did get the pink ones as well, but I sold them just because, I don't know, I didn't really like them that much. I mean, I did like them, but just for my style, they weren't really fitting, but I did get them because I wanted to make a review. And, yeah. And I remember the green and orange ones, I actually went to the skate shop, and they had all the other colors, but the green and orange ones, they hadn't sent the shipment in yet, so I had to get those shipped to my house later. But I guess I'll start out with probably color-wise my favorite pair. This is the blue and red. This was a really cool year. You had the yellow golf tags. The insole was the Flognal Motors, where if you put both of them together, they match up. The insoles on these were kind of weird. They kind of really are, like, curved on the inside. So if you have, like, flat feet, these weren't as comfy as, per se, like, the last ones. But yeah, here's this color. And we got, like, the classic yellow, blue, red, Caillou colorway, as I would call it. Yellow suede, blue, like, canvas. It's really rare to have, like, Vans back then that had a red stripe. You had, like, the light blue lining. Yeah. Cool shoe. I actually get the most compliments on this colorway out of all of these three. Then we have the orange, green, and blue colorway. Same insole. You had the green Vans logo on the back. Really cool colorway. This one really grew on me after time. And these just came in like a standard Vans box. I'm not sure why they kind of downgraded then. Maybe because it wasn't Syndicate. And then up next, this is kind of when Tyler switched to Converse. I didn't get the first blue ones that came out, but I did get the yellow ones from the next run. These aren't the LeFleurs per se, but just the Converse Flower Boy kind of collab. Say they have like the Water Your Garden stunt on the side, the LeFleur like Stitch logo, the B on the back embroidered, the Flower Boy print that's kind of like the same as the button-ups they had, and then Golf LeFleur embossed right there. I've had my hands on all of the other, or at least seen in person, all of the other pairs. I had my hands on the blue ones. I did a review on those, but I bought those for my friend. And then I also bought a pair of purple ones for my friend and a pair of pink ones. I never actually had them in my hands, but I've seen them wearing them before. And those are really nice as well. And then up next came the next drop of LeFleurs. You had the green and blue one, which is like the original from the fashion show. Orange bottoms with that like really like fine like fuzzy suede on there. Golf LeFleur embossed, and then just like a plain white Golf LeFleur insole. Nothing on the back, because the Golf LeFleur Unos kind of keep it more plain. Really nice shoe. And then probably the one I wear the most out of any of my LeFleurs so far is like the off-white cream one. Nothing on the back again, same insole, same embossed logo, same orange bottom, but they go really well with almost any outfit, so I wear these a lot, but I try to keep them clean, not too dirty, because I want to have them last. And then the newest ones I just got the other day in the mail are the Bachelor Blue, which I absolutely love this color in person. It's so nice, this light blue. Like, it's probably my favorite color, so to have a shoe in that is really nice. Orange bottoms, nothing on the back, same insole. And then Golf LeFleur embossed. And all of, like, the the cream and the green ones come with three laces each. One in orange and then one that matches the color of each shoe. And then these come in the pink LeFleur box that looks like this, the Converse box. And then, yeah, I want to say that wraps up my collection as of right now at the end of January. Yeah, so if you want to see individual up-close detail videos of any of these, they're all in my Golf Wang playlist. Plus the ones that I said I got rid of, they're all in there. So if you want to check those out, and make sure to subscribe. And I'll catch you next time.